Hi friends, Steve Welty here, broker owner at Good Life Property Management. A lot of questions about whether now is the time to sell your property or should you continue renting it. So I wanted to give you a series of videos to help you look at this topic in depth so you can make the right decision for you. This video is just gonna cover looking at the numbers. So the first thing you wanna do on the rental side is figure out what is your net income each year. And you do that by taking your rental income minus all your expenses. Now in San Diego, usually this number is negative because we are in an appreciation market as opposed to a cash flow market like areas of Tennessee in the South where you can get a big cash flow each month. In San Diego, it's more difficult to cash flow, but you get a lot better appreciation in markets like San Diego. So let's say on a $500,000 home, you are negative $500 a month after everything. That would be $6,000 a year. So let's say you put down $100,000 on that home, so you have $100,000 in cash invested, and you lost $6,000, so that's a negative 6% return, which sounds really bad, right? But before you go to make the decision to sell, I'd like you to look at two things. Number one, the appreciation, and number two, the tax benefits. So of that $6,000 loss, you can write that off of your income. Now, if you earn $100,000 or less, you can write it off up to $25,000 a year. $100,000 to $150,000 earned income, it starts to phase down. And then if you earn over $150,000 a year, you can't write passive losses from real estate off of your earned income, but you can write them off other passive losses. If you don't have other passive losses this year, you could write it off future years because it carries over. Or if you never get other passive income to write it off against, you can write it off eventually when you sell the property. So another thing to look at is depreciation. Rental real estate allows you to depreciate the home over 27 and a half years. You take the value of the home minus the land. So let's say $500,000 home, let's say the land is worth $100,000. That gives you $400,000 divided by 27 and a half years gives you $14,545 you get to write off each year from your home, from owning your rental home. Now, you do have to add that back eventually when you sell, but while you own the property, it is a great additional write-off that you wouldn't otherwise get. Now, let's look at 5% on a $500,000 home in appreciation. That's $30,000 a year. So in this example, you lost $6,000, but you earned $30,000 in equity. So that's a net $24,000 gain. Now, let's just look at finally what the numbers for a 5% appreciation look like over 30 years. Year five, it's $638,000. Your $500,000 home is now worth $638,000. After 10 years, it's worth $815,000. 15 years, you've hit the million mark. And then 20 years, $1.3 million. And after 30 years, that $500,000 home is now worth $2.2 million. And all this time, you had the renter paying off your mortgage, paying the vast majority of all the expenses, and you have a paid off home that's worth $2.2 million. Real estate is also a great hedge against inflation as well. Any questions on this or you'd like to discuss your particular situation, I'd be more than happy to help you. Thank you for watching. Make it a great day.